Hi guys, welcome to my new video. I'm the creator of the game called Snappy Mouse Run. In the last video, we talked about the edit mode and added a mirror modifier to our object in Blender 2.8. In this video, we'll model the mesh in edit mode. Again, the goal is to make the mesh match the underlying image in front, the side, and the top view. Let's start with the front. In the front, we only need to edit the right side since the left side is mirrored using the previously added mirror modifier. Let's model the right side. Deselect everything, go to vertex select mode by pressing this icon over here or just press 1 on your keyboard. Zoom in a bit and we want to get the shape of the teapot on the reference image. We can do this by moving every vertex by ourselves. This means selecting every vertex and moving them into place. Let's just zoom in a bit, press shift and middle mouse button to position your view. And if you for instance select this vertex over here with left mouse button and move it around by pressing G, only one vertex gets selected, but there is also another one on the other side. Press right mouse button to cancel. And if we hide our reference images, we can see this more clearly and move again. So you can see there is also one on the other side and we want both of them selected. So cancel this, box select them both. And if you rotate the view, we see both of them selected. And if you move them now, both are moving. Let's go back to the front view, unhide the reference images. And we can now move them around. And also we want that our movement is constrained only on the x-axis. So with the move tool selected, just press X on your keyboard. And now you can only move on the x-axis. You can constrain the movement on the other axis as well by pressing Y for the y-axis. But you cannot see in this perspective, but you can see in the side view. Pressing 3 on your keyboard. This is our selected vertex and the one on the other side. And if you press G and Y, you can constrain it on the y-axis. And also, if you press G and Z, you can constrain it on the Z-axis. Back to our front view. So what we want is to move all the vertices into position. For instance, like this. Constrain it on the X-axis. So to get the shape. Or there is another way. Let's just undo all this by pressing Ctrl Z a few times. And there is another way we can put them into place by using our scale tool. To do this, select one row, select the scale tool or press S on your keyboard and we see it scales around the median point. By default, cancel it. But we want that it actually scales around this middle vertex over here. So the vertex here should be our pivot point. The pivot point can be changed using this drop down over here. So currently it's set to median point. And since there is no vertex option, we will put our 3D cursor to the vertex position and use the 3D cursor as our pivot point. So select the 3D cursor in the pivot dropdown. Select only those two vertices. Again, there is also one on the other side, so both need to be selected. Press Shift S and select cursor to select it. The 3D cursor now jumps to the selected, and if we rotate the view around, we see the 3D cursor is placed at the median point of the two selected vertices. Front view again, select the entire row, press S to scale, and it scales around our pivot point. So we can move all of the vertices more evenly. Another advantage that we get with this approach is that we don't need to constrain the scale only on the x-axis, since all vertices and the pivot are on the same plane. And additionally, since the teapot is cylindrical, this approach is especially good because without constraining the scaling, we actually scale it on the y-axis as well. Let me just rotate the view so we can see the scaling on both axes in action. So this is our y-axis and this is our x-axis. If you press S to scale, we scale on both axes. And this way, we also get the right shape in the side view. So you see, the side view is also modified. And this saves us some work in the side view. Back to the front view again. And I will try to encourage you to use this approach by doing all the rows now to demonstrate how quickly this goes. Select these two, Shift S, cursor to select it. Select this, scale. These two, Shift S, cursor to select it, the whole row, scale. This one, Shift S, cursor to select it, scale. This, Shift S, cursor to select it, scale. Now on the top, put it a bit down by constraining the move on the z-axis. I will leave the top open. Also at the bottom, do the same. If you're not satisfied with the shape, you can easily add some more loops by pressing Ctrl R. I will place another one here. For this part, the front view looks okay to me as it is. Let's take a look at the side view. And since we scaled also on the Y and X axis, the side view also looks pretty good. Maybe only minor corrections here and there. Let's just move the whole loop down a bit. If you look in the front view again, let's see the top view. Press 7 on your numpad, press 8 to select everything. Okay, looks like the image is a bit in the way. If I rotate, yep. Tap out of edit mode. Again, by pressing tab, you can enter or leave the edit mode. Select our top image, go to object in the properties and move it to -1 on the Z location. This should be fine. Again, top mode, select our teapot and tap back to edit mode. So we see the top isn't really symmetrical and maybe the image itself is a bit deformed, since if we select the faces, these faces should cover the top and we see the cover on the top image is stretching way out of the bounds. So that's this line over here. And if you look in the front view or at the side view, you see the faces are nearly the same size as the cover. I would say in this case, since the top image is deformed, we will not focus too much on the top view. But the image is still ideal for texture extraction, and we will do this in some later video exclusively devoted to texturing and UV mapping. Let's take a look how our object looks in object mode. Let's just hide the reference images and turn on the solid view. So this would be our object. Let's turn off the X-ray. And in the next video, we will do the rest of the object. Okay, thank you for watching and make sure to give a like and subscribe if I've helped you to learn something new and you want to see more tutorials like this. It means a lot to me. Thanks again and I will see you in the next video. Bye.